The country is still struggling to come to terms with the fact that a bodyguard who was trusted to protect his boss killed him. The tragic shooting of former State Minister for Labour Samuel Okello Engola on Tuesday by his bodyguard Wilson Sabiti in Chanja, Kampala, has shone a light on the burden of poor mental health in security forces. Uganda Police Force, which has had officers go on shooting sprees, admitted mental health challenges in 2022 and rolled out counseling as one of the ways to ensure mental fitness, but the Ministry of Health wants to do more. They want Parliament to pass a 1 billion shilling budget to cater to efforts to boost mental health, a prevalence study's priority, they say, as they tackle an issue that is increasingly deadly.
So we recognize that even if we are treating 100,000, we are not even touching the tip of the iceberg. So that's why our hearts are warm that we are here with members of Parliament. Our hearts are warm that we are here with the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Health, with other partners in the civil society space, to ensure that we are shining a spotlight on the needs in the community.
With the funding, psychiatrists are confident they will come up with low-cost interventions.
We need to invest in the community services. We need to invest in integrated services and other preventive modalities in order to prevent the burden of care of the mentally ill.
As Sharon Nabasiri reports, depression, post-traumatic stress disorder and anxiety are some of the leading causes of mental health disorders, and experts agree more needs to be done.